The Judgement is a story of alienation, memory, and the lines between fantasy and reality. The protagonist of this story is a young merchant, a man called Georg Benjamin. He was writing a letter to his friend, who left for Russia a few years ago to start a business, one that showed a lot of promise initially but is now in a fragile state. He remembered how his friend bitterly complained during his rare visits and thought how he was pointlessly grinding himself in a foreign country. Georg contemplates whether he should advise his friend to come back and resume all his old friendships, but he doesn't try it, as it might sound mean. Georg's mom died 2 years ago and he was taking care of the business and his elderly father since then. Georg has been having tremendous success in managing his own business. Perhaps as his father has insisted on running the business o his own way during mother's lifetime and prevented him from making his own mark. Or maybe his mother's death made his father inactive, he thought. Until now, he has only been giving his friend little pieces of information. And not that frequently either. He often spoke about his friend to his girlfriend. Georg doesn't want to call him on his marriage as he thinks he might feel hurt and even jealous. But now he decides to let his friend know about his upcoming marriage to Frieda Brandenfeld, a girl from an affluent family. And how happy is he in his life? After finishing the letter, Georg decides to check on his father, to whom he rarely sees, and let him know of his intentions and seek his approval to break this news to his friend. Although quite ill and heartbroken after his wife's death, his father appears huge to him. His father questions the existence of his friend and blames Georg for keeping him in the dark regarding his business dealings. He also attacks him personally, saying that the death of his mother didn't impact Georg as much as him. Embarrassed by his father's accusations, he stood up and says he is not taking good care of himself and should his habits, and offers to take him to the hospital. He insists that he lay on bed, rest for a while and get his strength back. But the father claims that he's only asking him to lay on the bed because he wants him dead. In a fit of rage, he also admits to knowing all about his friend and that he has been informing his friend about everything that has been happening in Georg's life. He ridicules Georg about his fiancée, mocks her, and implies that he doesn't value anyone but himself. He completely disregards Georg's love and care. Georg, deeply hurt by his father's statements, recoils. His father's anger still rages on. He calls Georg selfish and sentences him to death by drowning. Georg feels a strange but powerful force that pushes him out of the room. He then runs out of the house and onto a bridge. Then he swings himself off the railings and jumps to his apparent death, wherein the sound of the jump is muffled by sounds of traffic.